Welcome. I'm Patricia Sargent, and this is Industry Insiders, the show in which we chat with people who work primarily behind the scenes to support and promote the importance of literature. On this episode, we're getting the scoop from David Weaver, Executive Director of the Ohioana Library, which is based in Columbus, Ohio. So what's next for the Ohioana Library?
Well, as I said, you know, we've just been celebrating all this year our 90th anniversary. So we're looking forward to our next Ohioana Book Festival coming up. This will be our second year to be at the main library in Columbus, at the Columbus Metropolitan Library's main library, which was a great move for us. You know, it's interesting, the Ohioana Book Festival started in 2007 with 10 authors. And this past year, it was 140 authors. We had 500 attendees the first year. This past year, we had 4,400.
Wow.
So it was amazing. And the Ohio Humanities Council, I asked them, because they're one of our major funders for the book festival, and they said, you can legitimately claim that the Ohioana Book Festival is the single largest literary event in the state of Ohio, focused on Ohio literature. So we're very proud of that. And so we look to keep continuing to build on that. In 2 years will be the 15th anniversary of the book festival and the 80th anniversary of the Ohioana Book Awards. So we're only kind of started plowing, you know, where I like anniversaries because it gives you a chance to toot your horn. And you know, when you've been around for 90 years or 80 years or something, you know, it is something, because so many organizations or projects or programs don't last that long. So it's something that we have continued. And the other thing that we hope to do is, most people probably will never come to Columbus to see or experience the Ohioana collection in person. So we are looking to digitize more of the items that are in our collection, because we're not a rare books library, but we have a first edition from 1852 of Uncle Tom's Cabin.
Wow.
We have an 1898 edition of Paul Laurence Dunbar's first book of poetry.
Wow.
And we have some other incredible materials, biographical files. We have letters in our collection from Sherwood Anderson, from Langston Hughes, telegrams from Louis Bromfield, you know, that all come from like the first decade of our existence when we were just crazy. Really getting started. So, and obviously with the passage of time, you know, you want to be sure that those things are preserved. And also too, by digitizing them, then we can put them online and share them with people. So
truly, you know, I forgot to mention, people can get tours of the Ohioana Library.
Yes, they can. They can access us, you know, they can contact us. We're open Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. And they can just come in, or they can call and set up a tour. We do a lot of groups. We have a regular book club that meets every 3 months, the Ohioana Book Club, which is part of the Lifelong Learning Institute. And so we have people, and they'll pick a book and they'll read it as a group and discuss it. And many times we'll try and have an author come in and actually do a talk with them. So it's fun, and we try to like pull the people in to be part of the library. And of course, the State Library of Ohio, we have shared our facility. I mean, we started out as part of the governor's mansion, but within 5 years, we collected so many books that we were not able to stay anymore. So we moved to the brand new, at that time, State Department of State building on South Front Street. We were there until 2000, at which time then that building became totally dedicated to the Supreme Court of Ohio. And so we in the State Library, which had shared a facility, began looking for somewhere else. So now we're in the Jeffrey Mining Center. And it's wonderful, and people can go to our facility, the State Library. You can actually get a library card at the State Library and borrow a book from any library across the state. Now, people ask about Ohioana and about the fact, oh, can I borrow books? Our library is, as a special library, is non-circulating, because part of what we are is to preserve books.
Right.
So unlike public libraries, which will weed their collections, you know, a book after so many years, you know, would just be remandered or put in the friend's book sale or something of that nature. Once a book comes in our collection, it stays there because, again, we are in essence, we're documenting. I mean, you as an author, we are documenting your contributions to the literary life of Ohio. That's why what Jerry Lawrence said about the literary Fort Knox, you know, it's like, yeah, every book that goes in our collection is like a gold bar. So.
It is.
and actually, I mean, Laura Bickle, who's a good friend of ours and has written a book and come to the Ohio Book Festival. The first time she was the book festival and heard me talk about, you know, preserving, you know, the contributions of authors. And she said, you know, wow, that's, you know, that's pretty cool. I mean, I'm just thinking, I'm writing these books. I hope people will like them and buy them. And she said, I never thought about I'm making a contribution to Ohio literature. But she was, and you are, and everyone else who's writing is.
That is awesome. Well, how can people find out more about Ohioana?
Well, they can find us on the web at www.ohioana.org. And we're very active on social media. We're on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram. We try and keep things updated, you know, for people as to what's going on. A lot of what we do on our Facebook page is to share information about other authors and things. So it doesn't necessarily even have to be related to Ohio. And again, it's that whole cheerleading concept, you know. Last week or just a few days ago, Hanif Abdurraqib, you know, was named as a long-listed finalist for the National Book Awards. Well, that is pretty cool, pretty fantastic. And so we shared that information because, again, you know, it's, hey, you know, here's another Ohio author, and they're doing great things, and great things are happening for them. So, and we want you all to be aware of that.
That's fantastic. And just to go back to the Ohioana Book Festival, it's really important to me that we stress that event provides literature for all ages.
Yes.
Little kids, fiction, nonfiction, is very diverse.
Yes. We have authors who are there for like preschoolers, middle grade, young adult. We have genre fiction, we have literary fiction, we have history, we have biography, we have poetry. And then we have, you know, especially like, you know, with like I said, young people, children, we'll have a number of authors who do picture books like Tim Bowers and Lindsay Ward and folks like that and everything who are writing for the littlest kids and everything to just introduce them to reading. And most of their books are all pictures, you know, with some words, you know, to introduce children to reading.
But these kids are serious about their reading. You'll see these tiny kids with book bags as big as they are carrying their books around. These are serious readers.
Yes, it's really fantastic.
Yeah, the Ohioana has a wonderful event, and I'm so glad that the library is there for us. So, in closing, is there anything that you want to share with our viewer readers about Ohioana or about the book life?
I would just say thanks to everyone for keeping, you know, the love of reading alive. And the thing that I always say when people say, well, why should I get involved or be involved or be interested in Ohioana? And I said, if you love books, if you love reading, you know, this is your home, baby.
And it's a great home. David, thank you so very much for joining us today.
Thank you, Patricia.
You've given us so much great information about the library and the association, and I really appreciate your time.
Thanks. See you at the book festival.
Oh, I look forward to it. And thank you to our viewer readers for joining us on this episode of Industry Insiders. Join us next time when we get the scoop from another insider. Until then, happy reading.